In homes across America tonight, from Highfield Lane to County Road 170, from rural Georgia to Walnut Avenue in New Jersey, every third house in the neighborhood on average has guns inside. Some locked, some hidden, some out and loaded. 1.7 million children live where there are unlocked and loaded guns, and friends come to play.
There's one right there. It's pretty hard to find that one.
It's up there, Mom.
Sitting on the kitchen table.
I have it in my Juicy Couture box.
Loaded guns on a bookshelf, under a pillow, in a backpack, even a diaper bag.
A handgun in a child's diaper bag.
But so many of the moms and dads are certain they have taught their high-energy children do not touch and do not play with guns.
They know the consequences of not being safe with it.
They're not toys, they're to be respected.
They are taught to not touch them at a young age.
So we wondered, what are young children doing when parents are not looking? Come with us to McManus School in St. Petersburg, Florida, which helped us find parents and kids, nearly all of whom had been taught don't touch a gun and tell an adult. 44 children, and we took half of them to reinforce that message. The St. Petersburg police gave a safety class, and they looked at the popular video from the NRA, Eddie Eagle.
Now stop, don't touch, leave the area, tell an adult.
Stop, don't touch, leave the area, tell an adult.
The kids have it cold. Working with us, Professor Marjorie Sanfilippo of Eckerd College, a published expert in pediatric psychology and gun safety. And so we are ready. With full permission of the parents, we put 7 cameras inside a room, in toy bins, and the butterfly on the ceiling. And then, after a few days, the St. Petersburg police give us guns, real guns, unloaded. We place them in a room, candy on the table nearby. And again, these are 44 good kids, most of whom know the rules by heart, and parents about to get the shock of their lives. As we begin, this first group of boys are about to show you something you will see over and over again.
Oh, no.
Their words say, don't touch that gun.
Back away from it.
But their bodies can't seem to help it. Think of it as a dance of temptation at the table.
Tell it to.
And then around the room. Even as they are chanting the rules a total of 20 times. They know to do it, but they do not. And 6 minutes after finding that gun,
don't touch gun.
They touch and dance again. Our second group of boys is about to do the same.
Don't touch.
But they take only 2 minutes, not just to touch, but to pound the barrel.
Ow.
And then the third group.
Don't mess with it.
Within 10 minutes, they take the gun out and do this. Professor Sanfilippo says that is a scene that is too often played out in real life.
These 3-year-olds who shoot themselves in the head, for whatever reason, it's a natural thing to look down the barrel.
Right afterwards, this young boy narrates what he's doing as he's crossing the line.
I'm breaking it. Oh, yeah.
His friend shows this is how you check to see if a gun is real. Finally, after they've had time to play, they get around to those rules.
Help! Help! We found a gun! 2 guns! I mean 3 guns.
Did you guys touch it when I was gone?
No. Yes. Yep.
You did touch it when I was gone?
We did touch it.
Did you touch it?
Yeah.
No, you didn't?
And then what happens with our fourth group of boys? Well, Professor Sanfilippo has barely left the room when one of them sees the gun and in 6 seconds has pointed it at his face. They put it back, pull it out.
It's not funny.
And then aim at each other. Another child trying to figure out a gun by staring down the barrel. And what kid gets a gun in his hand and doesn't want to pretend he's in the movies?
Put the gun down!
Dude, that is a real gun. It's not funny.
Professor Sanfilippo had seen enough.
Hey, guys.
It's not a real gun.
Yes!
Right here.
Oh, okay, oh, but what are you touching it for?
The professor and the police officer asked for clarification.
We both knew not to pull it. And the first thing we were going to do when you came back in
was going to tell you
this. And you did. You told me right away. And then you picked it up and pointed it at me.
We weren't going to, like, fire it or anything because we're both smart enough to know not to pull it.
Here we are, four groups of boys, and our expert says a powerful truth.
They can learn the knowledge. They could sit down, we could ask them to repeat it, but you can't educate curiosity out of a child.
So you may be wondering, were there any kids who did follow the rules, and who were they?